Hello and welcome to Finding Articles in OneSearch, our library resource search engine. In this tutorial, we will show you how to access OneSearch, how to look for articles in the search engine, how to retrieve those articles, and highlight some of the tools available in OneSearch to help you save and cite your research. To access OneSearch, go to the library homepage, which you can get to by typing the words CPP Library into Google or the search engine of your choice. Now, there is a OneSearch search box located front and center on the library homepage, but to do a search for articles, you should click on the Advanced Search link here. This will take you to the Advanced Search page for OneSearch. Above the search boxes, you will see a series of radio buttons that focus your search on a specific subset of the collections that OneSearch can search. The default setting in OneSearch is Everything, which means everything. All of the books in our catalog, all of the books in the 22 other CSU libraries' catalogs, and all of the articles in all of our databases that OneSearch interfaces with. Generally speaking, you don't want to use everything as your search unless you know exactly what you want to look for and have that title ready. Instead, to search for articles, click on the radio button marked Articles. Now, OneSearch will limit its searches to the library databases it interfaces with, and will provide you with results that come from those databases only. Now, an important thing to remember here is that OneSearch does not interface with all of our library databases. There are some that don't play well with OneSearch, so if you don't find the results you're looking for through OneSearch, you should check out our databases page and then look for databases under your subject to search them too. Okay, so we've set up OneSearch to search for articles. Now we need to have something to look for. In this case, let's choose the search terms sustainable architecture. You'll notice that I've put these search terms in quotation marks. This tells the database that I'm looking for sources that have those two exact words in that exact order. So, I hit search, and we end up with almost 4,000 hits, which is a bit much. So there are a couple things I can do to narrow down my search results. First off, I can add more keywords to my search in order to make it more specific. So we'll scroll up. Maybe I'm interested in how solar power can be used in sustainable architecture. So I'm going to add in the keyword solar power, once again in quotation marks, and hit search. And I've brought down our results from nearly 4,000 to now about 80, which is better, but still a lot. So now I can use another tool to help filter my results. This is OneSearch's filter menu, which is located on the left-hand side of the screen. Let's say I'm only interested in material that comes from peer-reviewed journals. Then I can go over to the menu bar, and under the Available at CPP heading, I can click on the filter marked Peer-Reviewed Journals. This cuts the results down to about 30, which is a pretty manageable set of results. So now I have a set of search results. How do I determine which articles I want to look at? Well, one of the key things to know about academic journal articles is they have really boring titles. No, seriously, have a look at all these articles and you'll see that they have really long titles that just basically describe what the article's about. And that's by design. The titles are required to be that way because it helps the reader understand what the article's about. So your first pass over your search results will probably involve looking at the titles and deciding from them which ones seem to most closely relate to what you're interested in. But if you're looking over this whole list, how do you remember which titles you want to go back to? No worries. Next to every entry in your search results is a little pin-shaped icon marked Add This Item. When you see an article you're interested in, click on the pin next to that article. And it will be saved to a folder for later viewing. So after you've saved a few articles, you're going to want to look a little deeper into them to see which ones you really want to keep. So how do you access your folder? Well, if you just scroll up to the top of the page, you'll see a pin icon that looks suspiciously like the pins you just clicked on, marked Go to My Favorites. Click on this link and scroll down, and you will access the items you just selected from the search results. If you want to save your results and access them later from another computer, log into your library account using your Bronco ID and password, and your selections will be saved. Which leads to your second sifting of articles, this time done by abstracts. What's an abstract? Well, if we click on one of our selections, we'll go to the catalog record for this article. If we scroll down the record to the section marked Notes, we will find a brief summary of the article, which explains what it's about. From reading the abstract first, you can determine whether or not the article you're looking at is relevant for your research before reading the entire article. Okay, so we've looked at the abstract and we like this article. We want it. How do we get it? Well, if we scroll back up towards the top of the record, you will see a link to one of the databases the library subscribes to. If you don't see these links, click on the button that prompts you to log in with your Bronco ID and password, and they will appear. Clicking on this link will allow you to access the database where your article is located and to download a PDF copy of it. While we're here in OneSearch, I should probably also point out a couple of other tools available to you while you're working in this search engine. Above the article title, you will see a series of buttons. These buttons let you access tools that will allow you to see how this article can be cited in a variety of different citation styles, copy a permalink to share this article or access it again in the future, print or email the article's record page, or export this article's bibliographic information to a variety of different citation management systems, including Zotero, EndNote, EasyBib, and RefWorks. Thank you for watching this tutorial. If you have questions about OneSearch or about research in general, contact the library. You can reach us through the 24/7 chat widget on the library homepage or via email at researchhelp@cpp.edu.